Welcome back to Movies, Money and More. We are aware of how the geographical lines between Hollywood and Bollywood are constantly blurring, with several movie makers crossing over. Shobnam Nair spoke to filmmakers Ashok Amritraj and Shekhar Kapoor to understand what they have to say about this.
Bollywood is one of the biggest movie industries across the world, and it has now woken up to the fact that apart from being creative and original, it also has to strategize and plan like any other business. With corporatization, more and more filmmakers are learning the tricks of how to get it right. Ashok Amritraj, India's biggest export to Hollywood, differentiates the way the two worlds function.
Indian cinema, Bollywood, Tamil cinema, all of that kind of walks its own path, and Hollywood is you know, we are on parallel paths. I think there are certain things that the Indian cinema industry takes from Hollywood, which is big releases the first weekend, which is now the sequels and all of these kind of things, prequels as well. And I think those are all good things. There's nothing wrong with any of that. But the methods of working are completely different. And I think some here work differently than others. But I think overall, there is a certain system of working in Hollywood that has been there for 100 years. And you know, there's a certain system in Bollywood that's been there for 100 years. And I think there's an evolution going on. But it's going to be interesting to see where it all heads.
So there is an organized system and here is an unorganized system, the way you look it at?
No, the way I look at it is, how long did it take you to get from your house to the hotel? So there's a little bit of chaos, but at the end of the day, you got to my hotel. So, you know, but India seems to know how to manage the chaos and perhaps makes better movies because of that.
So even if India has a method to madness, it is an attractive market for Hollywood studios. But filmmaker Shekhar Kapoor, who directed the much-awarded Elizabeth and its sequel, has a word of caution for them.
Any market in this world, if you're going to make films for that market there, you have to inherently learn a lot about the culture. So the people who've been successful a lot in India completely come from this culture. So you can't go to any culture and sit upon it and say, okay, now I'm going to suddenly succeed by making films of this culture. But then you can go and bring into your corporation, into your company, people who completely understand the culture. That's how to do it. But if the attempt is to, well, I know what to do and I'll just take a Hollywood film, I'll copy it and make it, that doesn't work.
Over the years, the number of Hollywood releases has gone up in India, and so has the success ratio, though they still face stiff competition from Indian films.
I'm surprised that the Hollywood films are starting to do better in India. Seemingly, Avatar did well, and Spider-Man, and, you know, it's still a very, very small part of our business globally. You know, India is a tiny portion of the global market.
But you intend to make it big.
Well, you can only make it so big because Indian films will always be bigger in India. So I think depending on the number of screens, depending on the number of English screens that are growing, and always depending on the movie, I think the market will grow. But there will always be a ceiling when it's compared to Indian cinema, as opposed to a country like China, where, by the way, only 20 films are allowed in a year. Ghost Rider happens to be one of them. But on the other hand, you know, Avatar went out and did $120 million in China. So the box office grosses in China, to compare it to India, are far, far bigger for a Hollywood movie in China.
So you're saying China is a very attractive market in comparison to India?
It is. It is for the box office of Hollywood films, you know, for, I think, economic growth, both countries seem to be doing amazingly well. Neither one, by the way, is in the top 10 markets in the world. You know, so you have US and Germany, Italy, Spain, France, UK, all the European countries. Russia dominates now. It's a huge market for us. Brazil and Mexico are huge markets for us. So all of those are, you know, much, much larger than what an Indian market is.
While foreign studios are aggressively venturing in the Indian markets, and understanding the trends, there are Indian production houses aiming at making it global, Yashraj Entertainment being one of them.
Now, Indian films normally have a very traditional international market, which you call the NRA market. How do you go beyond that? Because let's face it, you know, Indian films normally peak out at about world box office at about 30 million, the big hits. There have been films across it, but around 25 million, 30 million is the biggest hits normally peak out at that. Even Slumdog Millionaire, a film with Indian actors, shot in India, with an Indian crew mostly, written on an Indian novel, it's done almost $400 million against $30 million. So there is a huge opportunity there to start to think internationally, not just Hollywood, but think Japan, China, Europe, Australia, all of that, to go beyond what we have as our traditional NRI market.
So one need to wait and watch how far Indian production companies can go on the global map.
Moving on to the movies which were released this week, Pratik and Amy Jackson star Ek Deewana Tha and Daniel Radcliffe's The Woman in Black. Take a look to find out what we think of them.
The town is cursed, but the house.
One of the most cliched yet scary scenes in The Woman in Black is seeing the ghost right behind the protagonist Arthur Kipps, played by Harry Potter's Daniel Radcliffe, when he's standing at the window. Watching The Woman in Black is like going back to old-fashioned horror films. The initial scenes in the film are enough to make you fidgety.
The Woman in Black.
And director James Watkins slowly and steadily ups the spook meter. With the creepy atmosphere, the film certainly has plenty of scares but fails to surprise. Radcliffe's refrained performance is enough to shrug off as the boy who lived image, but falls short of being a convincing father of a four-year-old. A haunted house, dark corridors, eerie noises, and a vengeful ghost. The Woman in Black is a good watch, even though it's old wine in an old bottle.
That tells you she's there.
Tum mujhe follow kar rahe ho?
Everybody wanna know, I feel like I really wanna be here with you.
Atom.
Gautam Menon, the director of Rehna Hai Tere Dil Mein, returns with Ek Deewana Tha.
Sachin, can we be in this without love? Humko dosti rehna chahiye. Friend Sachin.
A remake of the Tamil hit Vinay Tandi Varuvaya. The movie starts with the protagonist waiting for the love of his life to say I do. Sachin, played by Pratik Babbar, questions his love, and the movie just spirals down from there on. Slow screenplay, average acting, unimpressive music, and a cliched plot. Ek Deewana Tha has nothing going right for it. However, the movie's cinematography makes up for the lack of other elements. While the Tamil version was a huge commercial hit, it seems that Ek Deewana Tha forgot to take the right cues from the original.
Duniya mein itni saari ladkiyan hain par mujhe jaisi se hi kyun pyar hua?
On that note, it's time for a quick break, but on the other side of the break, we tell you how much Ek Mein Aur Ek Tu collected at the box office.